This is for BaroneRocks.com. I'm Eric Valderrama, and today helping me is my lovely sister, Danielle. So I'm going to use these cards right here. Have you guys heard of the story of the stem cell family? Have you heard of the story of the stem cell?
No.
No? Okay. I'm going to let the cards tell you the story. So once upon a time lived a cell in the bone marrow. Not just any regular cell. This guy was a stem cell who dressed like a king. Yeah. Anyway, so this stem cell, he married another beautiful stem cell who turned out to be the queen of his heart. And everyone could tell from miles away, from 3 miles away, 1, 2, 3, what CD number was showing on their surface, which was CD 34. They were very madly in love with each other and decided to have a big family. They had a bunch of sons. I'm going to cut this 4 times to show that they had 4 boys. This was a very, very patriotic family. They grew up in the bone marrow and decided to move out and join the military. That's how patriotic they were. How about you give this a cut? Now, each boy has a little story, and I'm going to tell you each of their stories. So the first son, he was a good eater and a good killer. So when he joined the military, they gave him the nickname Mac. Why? Because he liked to eat mac and cheese? No. Because he was a macrophage. And so they gave him his identification number, which was CD14. 1, 4. You have to use your imagination here. Ace counts as a 1. The next son, he was a natural at what he did. Yeah, he was a good killer. He was a natural killer. His nickname was NK. Get it? NK? You see the K right there? So when he joined the military, his CD number was CD 56. Yeah. The next 2 sons, these guys were twins. See, they're black. They're blackjacks. They're tall. So their nickname was T. T for tall. So this guy, he was a good specialized killer. He was good at protection, foreign and domestic. So his nickname was Cytotoxic. How do you give this a cut? Yeah, his nickname was Cytotoxic. So when he joined the military, his CD number was CD8. The next son, he was also a good killer, but he actually was more of a lover, not a fighter. Yeah, he was good for helping everyone. He was for helping everyone. He was the 4th son. 1, 2, 3, 4. So since he was the 4th son and he was for helping everyone, he was nicknamed Helper Cell. He's a T Helper 4 Cell. See? 4. So those were the first 4 boys that this mom and dad had. They also decided to have 3 daughters. Give this a cut. I'm not going to cheat. No, really cut it. How about this time you complete the cut so you don't think I'm cheating? Complete it. Okay, that just makes my job a lot harder. So these, the mom and dad decided to have 3 daughters. 3 daughters, 2 brunettes, and a redhead. That's right. They also decided to join the military. But these were sophisticated girls. They didn't like to go on the battlefield and just fight. They liked to hit a little button and send these missiles out to do their attacking. Those were the antibodies. So that's how they did their attacking. They were young and beautiful, just like their mom. So I don't know how old they were. They were about like 19, 20, 21. But whenever you guess a girl's age, you always want to guess younger. So I would say that they were about 19. 1 and 9. Oof. Okay, I can fix that. Watch this. Look, I'll take that 4 and I'll go like this. There, we got it. We got a 9. You see that? They were 19. CD 19. Get it? So these were B cells. They were B cells. They were CD 19. That's why they used to attack from far away. Now, I'll do it again just in case you didn't get that. But I'll take this card here and I'll put it like this. And I give it a little rub. And all that does is gives me a little space to put the mom and dad there in the middle. And this is the story of the stem cell family that protected the body. Thank you very much. I'm Eric Valderrama. Thank you, Danielle, for helping me out. This is for BaroneRocks.com.